ignorance, people. Man, the ignorance in the horse world just doesn't stop. So, this so-called trainer in Iowa named Logan Allen is getting heat, and he's defending this. He has tied this horse's legs up, squirted him with water, covered him with a tarp, and then squirted him with more water. And if you listen to his interview, he kind of tells, he's calling this training, it's absolutely abuse and it's bullshit. And he's defending it, saying he loves horses. And there'll be people that believe him. He's a good guy. He's a good trainer. He's some rodeo star or something in Iowa doing something. Let's look at the news on this guy. Now, the date on this is 2016. I'm just hearing about it. I don't know why I'm just hearing about it, whether it's in news or he's going to court or what's happening. But I don't even think he was charged. Let's take a look.
Pair. He tells us the horse is just fine and that he loves his animals. Other images.
He loves his animals. Really?
He shared online showed the horse with legs tied being sprayed with water. Tonight, he wants to clear up any confusion about that post.
He wants to clear up the post. Really? You post a picture of that horse tied up with the caption, bad boy, trying to show how macho and cool you are, how you can take advantage of an animal that doesn't fight back because you're a freaking pussy and a punk, and you're going to come here and try to clear it up? I call bullshit.
Logan Allen says...
Oh, look at him. He's got a nice cowboy hat on. He must be a good guy. He must know what he's doing, right? Yeah, because what a person wears tells everything, right?
Horses are his partners.
I love horses more than anybody out there.
You don't love horses more than anybody, dude. You freaking abuse horses. You use horses to make money. You use horses to feed your ego so you can dominate and abuse them. And then you want to claim that it's training and that you don't hurt horses and you love them. You're pretty much full of shit. I'm pretty sure your hat can't hold the amount of shit that you're full of.
Every day I use horses.
You do use horses to feed your ego and for abuse.
And the last thing I'm going to do is hurt one.
You're full of crap. Oh, look at him. He's got a nice, pretty horse. He's riding.
Allen has been a rancher and horse trainer near Glenwood, Iowa his whole life.
Horse trainer his whole life. Hell, he's almost as good as that woman that was riding horses since before she was born. He's been a horse trainer his whole life. I was at a barn the other day with my buddy looking at his horse, and a girl walks up to me and goes, are you a horse trainer? She saw me working with his horse. I go, no, I'm a horseman. I'm not a fan of people that call themselves horse trainers because they're usually full of shit and they just abuse horses. But anyway, I digress.
Here's video of him from 2012 when he helped rescue half a dozen cattle along an Omaha freeway.
Oh, he helped rescue cattle because he was going to get to keep them or because he was going to get some good publicity and get his name out there. Now, all of a sudden, he's trying to tell me that tying down a horse and putting a tarp over him, squirting with a hose, which everyone else is calling waterboarding. I'm not sure it's waterboarding because waterboarding is actually pouring water in his face where it can get through and give you the feel of drowning. This is just flat out fear. The Amish used to do this shit and says, oh, if you make a horse fear and you take away his ability to flight, he'll know that when you come bring him water or you come help him and untie him, he'll know you rescued him and he'll love you forever. It's freaking stupid.
Allen posted these photos on Facebook earlier this month.
Okay, so in this one, he's got him tied up. That wasn't enough to tie him up and squirt him with water. I'm going to cover his tarp, which makes a lot of noise, and scare the crap out of him so that when the water hits the tarp, it makes more noise and scares the crap out of him. The tarp will take away his ability to see, so not only can he not run, not only can he not see, I'm going to make a lot of noise and do this. And you know what this guy said? I was desensitizing him. Really? This is not how you desensitize. You desensitize through getting responses and not reactions. You desensitize by helping the horse deal with their fear, not scaring the shit out of them. Absolutely outrageous.
One with the caption, bad boy. The pictures went viral, leading to a lot of calls to local law enforcement and to KETV Newswatch 7.
It just got twisted.
Alan,
it didn't get twisted. I'm looking at the picture. You tied a freaking horse up because you can because you're a brutal asshole, and then you put a tarp over him, and you have no idea about prey animal instincts and the fear that they go through when they can't run and they can't see. You're a freaking idiot.
One says he is not hurting the horse in this picture.
See, because he says he's not hurting it, doesn't make it so. Because he says he loves a horse, doesn't make it so. This is abuse. He is hurting the horse. He's destroying this horse's confidence and brain.
He says it's actually an old technique called laying a horse down.
That's not laying a horse down. I lay a horse down. And I don't put a tarp and squirt him with paper and do that. That's bullshit.
Alan says he was trying to wash off mud when the horse started acting up.
See, here's the key. He was trying to wash off mud and the horse started acting up. Meaning he was such a dumbass trainer, he never desensitized the horse to hose. He didn't figure out how to make the horse accept the water. He just wanted to say, the horse is acting up. This is a horse problem. I'm going to teach this horse a lesson. I'll tie him up, cover him with tarp, and scare the shit out of him, and show him who's boss. You're a brutal ego jerk.
He tells us he used this method to get the animal used to water.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure let's get the animal used to water. How about I get you used to being dragged behind my truck? If I tie you up and drag you behind my truck, that'll get you used to it, right? That makes as much sense as your dumbass explanation of how you're abusing his horse.
It's just a technique that some people do with their horses.
Idiots do it. Not some people. Idiots. Ego. Ignorant people do it. People that have no compassion, no knowledge, no empathy for a horse. That's who does this. Not some people.
Gain trust in the absolute worst.
Gain trust. Are you kidding me?
Some people do with their horses to gain trust.
Really? This is how this guy gains trust? I bet you he beats the shit out of his wife and says, baby, I'm just trying to gain your trust. I gotta hit you so you know you can trust me. Really? What a freaking idiot.
And the absolute worst thing you can do when you lay one down is hurt him. And I did not hurt him.
We spoke with another horse owner who tells us times have changed.
Now,
a similar...
Which he's a little concerned, not as much as he, as some horses. Hey, thank you.
Different...
They use these women with this sensitive emotional crap, and then all the guys out there kind of go, oh, they got some sense of... Look, I'm not saying these women are necessarily wrong in what they're saying, but it doesn't... You're not going to convince a hardcore cowboy... When you come out there with your touchy-feely shit, and it kind of defeats the purpose of getting people to understand and think like a horse, that, hey, these are prey animals. This isn't emotion. This isn't some psychic, the stars are in line shit, and I'm trying to love this horse, and I want to bring him in my bedroom and sleep with him. This is about understanding a horse's fears and their prey and predator, their survival instincts, their flight instincts to run, and deal and working within those limitations that a horse can deal with and making it easy for a horse to learn and accept new things. That is different than the emotional, I love it, and, you know, but whatever.
Owners, different methods. And as Logan Allen shows us photos of his healthy horses, he says a picture like this does not tell the full story.
Tells a perfect story. You said bad boy. You said he acted up with water. This is how... You treat somebody who acts up in your opinion. This is how an ignorant person who sees every problem as a nail and his only tool is a hammer. This is you, dude. You are a pathetic human being. And for calling this training and having horses, you just suck, dude. I'm sorry. I don't know how to say it.
I do not hurt animals. I love animals.
You do not love animals. And if you do, if this is what you call love, I don't want you loving me. I got enemies that treat me better than the way you treat things that you love.
Now, I spoke with Mills County Sheriff Gene Goose tonight, who tells me they spoke with Logan Allen today, and he fully cooperated.
Oh, he fully cooperated. Isn't that nice? Hang on, there's another video of him.
Cover the animal in a tarp and blast it with water. Disturbing images viewed thousands of times on social media.
If it's so disturbing, how come he isn't criminally charged? How come it's not against the law? The sheriff, nobody's charging him because why? Because they look at horses as livestock and cattle and meat and something that people can abuse. If somebody did this to a dog, there would be outrage and the guy would probably be arrested. If somebody did this to a kid, they'd be arrested. But because it's a horse, you can do anything to a freaking horse. And it's like, it's just a dumb big animal. He's dangerous. You got to control him. You got to show him who's boss.
People outraged.
A petition calling for an arrest of Mills County man quickly spread from Iowa across the nation. Reporter Kelly Bartnick joins us now with the latest.
County Sheriff says the office is investigating and also...
County Sheriff said they're investigating. You know what that means? We ain't doing nothing. We got to tell you we're doing something because we ain't doing nothing. What's to investigate? The guy posted pictures of what he did to a horse. You have evidence. If it's a crime, then you arrest him. If it's not a crime, then you say, according to the picture, we don't see a crime. We're done. They ain't investigating shit, people.
Tonight, word from the horse's owner that this is all being turned into way more than it is. These are the pictures that sparked an online firestorm. They even started trending on Facebook as people call this horse waterboarding.
If the horse is alive, that was one of my concerns. Has this been photoshopped?
So when I see this rescue, I look around. I see cages. I see dirt. I see a bunch of horses standing around in mud and swallow, just like every rescue I see.
It wasn't.
Gina Stoops' phone started ringing. People from all over the country.
It's not okay. You're going to have repercussions because of this.
Stoops runs Hooves and Paws Rescue.
Nice sign. Nice rescue. Wow.
View of the Heartland near Glenwood.
Wow.
Where she is nursing dozens.
Wow, look at all these horses who are rescued. Man, they got a great life now, right?
Of animals back to health. Wednesday morning, she met with the horse in question and the trainer who posted them, Logan Allen.
He agreed. He said, I made a mistake.
He made a mistake. He didn't sound like he'd make a mistake when he's on the news. He said it's a training technique. And he wasn't hurting a horse, and he loves his horse. Guy's an idiot. He's got nobody. He's got no filter. Nobody's ever told him, you're being an idiot, you're being brutal, the horse is, knock it off. He's listened to rumors and a couple of hardcore, because he hangs out in rodeo types, and most rodeo types are abusive to animals. All sports are abusive to animals, whether it's horse racing, horse jumping, dressage. I don't care how you dress it up. All sporting events usually abuse horses, and it develops people that don't see the horse as a horse and a living thing. They see it as an object to win a medal, as a possession, as something to control, as something to show off on. It never is about the horse. Anything. Showmanship and horsemanship are two different things.
You know, I said to him, it was a huge mistake at the hands of an animal.
The images show the horse's legs tied as water is sprayed at it and also tarped. Allen said he was trying to desensitize the animal.
See, he's using terms. What a lot of people do is they get these fancy terms and they use, well, I was desensitizing him to the loud obstruction to his hearing properties because his ears are sensitive, and the desensitizing technique of a tarp actually helps his ears become accustomed to noise, and it makes him a calmer horse. You know, you talk this bullshit, and you'll have somebody going, oh, okay, that makes sense, because I don't know anything either. Because most people don't know what they don't know.
To a fear of water. By phone today, he says that process worked.
I did not.
See? He thinks it worked. It didn't work. He's an idiot. He just scared and beat the horse. This is how you get horses that have no life. This is how you get robot horses that stand there and people go, oh, that horse is really good. Look at him. He doesn't move. He just stands there. That's not a good horse. That's a horse that's been beat the life out of him.
Waterboard that horse of any sort or do any torture or do any harm to him.
If it's not torture, let me do it to you. See how you like it. Let me tie you up. Lay a tarp on you and put you out in the sun. Scare you. Let me start a car and race around you with the tarp over you so you don't know when I'm going to accidentally wreck and maybe run over you. Yeah, let's do that. Let's do some other fun things to desensitize you that people used to do, like bury you up to your head to where you can't see, and then we'll run wild horses by and you don't know if one's going to kick you in the head or stomp on you. And we'll desensitize you to being scared of horses running by. How about that? We'll call that desensitizing, you freaking idiot.
Stoops says Allen took the horse when he left her ranch Wednesday. She wants to see the animal surrendered and joined the rest here, providing at least some end to a social media saga that spread like wildfire.
Physically, on outward appearance, it's a good-looking horse. It's in good shape. Mentally, the horse is not in good shape.
What did she do? Some psychic exam on a horse? I mean, look, the horse got traumatized. It was bullshit. But it can recover if you get him away from idiots that treat him like a freaking machine.
I talked with an animal control officer from the Animal Rescue League in Des Moines today who says they're very concerned about this issue and also concerned that if nothing happens, it sends a message that these types of training tactics are appropriate.
That's exactly right. That's why the horse industry doesn't change, because you've always got somebody defending stupid shit like the big lick and horse racing a two-year-old and their legs break while they're running because they aren't even grown yet. And you got people defending it saying they got good health care. Oh, there's vets there and they got a lot of money and they're only carrying a little jockey, Rick. It's not that hard. And, you know, you can justify any type of abuse. Most people with two brain cells can figure out what abuse is. And this was absolutely abuse. And, all this BS about it's not and, you know, it's training and it's desensitized. It's all BS to me. Anyway. We'll end that there. Logan Allen. I tried to see his Facebook page now, and I can't find it. Looks like he's in Pacific Junction, Iowa. All right. We'll end that there. Buddy, Mr. T, you're good boys.